Hello, gentlemen, and welcome back to Let's Play Ultimate General Gettysburg. I have an extra cannon here, actually.
Yes, sir.
No, I don't. I just wanted to make sure that's full. Yeah, let's, make sure these guys are filled up. Apparently, they are not. I'm gonna send a second corps in to fight the Battle of, Something's Bayou. We just won the Battle of Gettysburg. And are consolidating their army, Jefferson Davis. We're gonna fight the Battle of Bayou Fourche. Having some trouble with my frames, and I haven't recorded in a long while. I've tried to find some bottlenecks to cut down on, but this seems to be about the best I can get. But long story short, there's 3 crossing points in the river. We're not taking Winning or Meredith, and instead we're taking some extra cannons, because I believe those will be essential. Let's go ahead and get to it real quick. I want these men to move up, set up along the road. These guys move over here. Let me see if there's any option, like, graphically I can do. I'm gonna turn off V-Sync and see if that does anything. Nothing terribly useful. Move up the 12-pounder over there. Move the 6-pounders over here. And I believe Lee has a 6-pounder. He has a 12-pounder. So we'll move him over here to set up Harland there. Garfield here. And our reinforcements over here. I want these boys to set up on that ridge. And I want Chapman and Beveridge to try and push across. And if they can push across and secure a foothold here, we'll march the other 3 down around and see if we can't come up the side over here. Take this area. Meanwhile, these 4 brigades will try and move up through the north and come down from the top. And hopefully the Rebs are gonna just plain run out of people. We'll go ahead and speed it up. Not much happening now besides the opening phases. I will order these men to run to get them out of the water, since the water is such a dangerous place. Starts by taking fire. Promptly returns fire at the skirmishers. Attacking up a hill is just plain suicide. I'm gonna try and send skirmishers across here. I want to make sure it's moving back this way. These guys are so kicked that assault. Six-pound doesn't really know where to position me. Richard is now in range of those skirmishers. They should break soon. Nothing terrifies a man more than 1,000 screaming mini balls tearing through his backside. Or, well, Sprint's backside in this case. Looks like the concentrated artillery on the southern crossers barely chatting down a notch. Most of those skirmishers have been pushed to flee, though. I'm gonna have these men, each one of a different division, try and push into this towards the field. I definitely expect to see them like dead, dude. I expect that to be a losing battle over there. Set up an edge. What's more of a defensive perimeter than anything else? I don't want those skirmishers to run out there and engage their skirmishers. Meanwhile, in the south, there's still a heavy firefight up the hill. Not much progress is going to be made, though. Beveridge is breaking even, surprisingly. Cannons are assuring that at some point the champion will probably break. Though he's not breaking quickly, that's fine by me. Meredith's men from Hell might rotate towards the north, but Whitney and Tyler are meant to push up this way, trying to sweep through the woods outside of the site. Meanwhile, I'm not really sure what a Confederate general is doing, but he's got more balls than most of his own men. Most great men, there's a guy who just fades away. Skirmishers are becoming a persistent problem over here. And we'll definitely need cannons to dislodge the enemy from that area. So now it's just a matter of waiting for the artillery to do its job and waiting for this push over here to throw back. Gunfire, my frames have been dying. Don't understand though. It's not that I have a bad just have a strange, grumpy one. Chapman and Beveridge are sitting in the shallow holes filled with the bodies of men they used to know and themselves. This crossing threatens to be a bloody Tyler gets off of his dog. Return those skirmishers to their parent formations. And the Confederate cavalry is all but massacred. Let's see if we can't push that flank right now. Cannons are firing on Meredith, and Meredith is firing on the cannons. Some skirmishers over here to put some rifle fire on as well, if at all possible. There's too many cavalry there to make that an effective push. There has been a general withdrawal along this line. Half of our time already just maneuvering, and we soon have to force the issue over here. Who's our best, team to be? Alright, Power gets the two. Straight in the church, I want to move up by firing the camera. I want Car to move up and Richard's will provide cover in the back. Church is gonna just move on in the church. Dre's just gonna have to make do with what he has. And Harland himself will head over there. See if we can't push north. I wanna see if Tyler can't try and reach the eastern portion of this encampment. We have a tough defensive enough to track over here. Deadwood back this way. Currently, our men are trading fire with cannons, and a musket fight with cannons. Riflesmen. I realized that was about as sensible a statement as George Bush in Iraq. So, whatever. Hopefully Carr is able to push this line. Richard can come up to the line as well. I suspect Carr is about to just throw it. Maybe it'll draw them out enough that we can get some of them. More men are distributed into the lines. Tyler's an advantageous position, but force that artillery. Chapman's still trading blows with Hawthorne. I want him to move up. Yeah. seems to me that there's a... Oh, there's only one way up this hill. Spirit to fall back to routes. No. Can definitely push up through this hole. Lost more soldiers in the game by this, but the expected cuts to the size of the army should make that a less of a problem. Condition to continue to fight. No, we have a breakthrough in the north. With that, we may be able to collapse that northern flank on the ribs. Across the river now. Just like that, we secured the other side. While on the east bank, it's as shitty as it ever was. I'm gonna set the car on him. in a car and Masur enjoy their own personal private hell. Rifle fire tears through bodies and men. The range is so short, one can't tell when to hit the target. An almost ridiculous cost of lives. But Little Rock will be ours, at this rate at least. Having taken 5,000 men casualties? Our medical supplies must be getting insanely good. Oh, wow, that's a lot of... Huh. Alan Carr was wounded, but the other men have all ranked up. We captured some more Harpus Ferries, and a lot of Confederate rifles. Not sure what that's for, considering I got it mostly for attacking. It seems our medical supplies have, is it our medicine? I'm unsure, but either way, I think our medicine needs to be upgraded, and a severe downsizing needs to occur. I suppose all that and more in the next episode of Let's Play Ultimate General Gettysburg. Until then, gentlemen, I've been your Commander Tomato. I will see this war to its end.